Joining me now from Tel Aviv is Dan Gillerman, former Israeli ambassador to the United Nations and a Fox News contributor. Ambassador, your thoughts on these reports that we are now hearing that indeed President Mubarak will step down and hand power to, we know not.
Well, Megan, this indeed is a watershed moment, not just for Egypt, but for the region. Many people have been comparing this to the fall of the Berlin Wall, and this could very well be, if not the fall of the pyramids, the fall of the pharaohs. As you know, Egypt has not had a democracy, not just for decades, but for thousands of years. The people are seeking democracy, and the big question is, will that happen? I think that these events indeed are watched by everybody in the region, and the big question is not only what's next, but who's next? Because the events in Egypt could have a very dramatic influence on other countries in the region, because this is Egypt. This is not Tunisia. This is not Yemen. This is the mother of the Arab world. And if the regime in Egypt has fallen, this could mark the beginning of real changes in the Gulf states, in other Arab countries, in Iran. And I'm sure the rulers and the people in those countries are watching very, very carefully.
Interesting questions about what a new democratically elected regime in Egypt would look like and what they would do in terms of policy when it comes to matters that concern Israel. Matters, Ambassador, like monitoring the smuggling, across the Egypt-Gaza border of arms, of how supportive will they be of Hamas in the region. How understanding will they be of Israeli concerns about Hamas and its acquisition of rockets and missiles and other weaponry, and whether the new Egypt, as we are about to see it, will be as protective of Israel as the Mubarak regime was?
Well, this is a very, very crucial question for Israel. For Israel, this is not just a matter of a change in history. For us, it's existential. But I think it's dramatic and important for the whole region and for the Western civilization as well. Because, as I said, Egypt is a pivotal country in the Middle East. It is indeed the mother of the Arab world. And therefore, I think it's very, very important that stability is maintained in Egypt. And I think that if the army indeed has taken over or is about to take over, that truly may be very good news, both for the Egyptian people, for Egypt, for the region, and for the United States and Israel and anybody who seeks stability in this very tough neighborhood and very volatile region. The army is very responsible. It is highly respected by the people. It is secular. It has maintained very close relations with the United States. I think it has the respect of the United States and feels close to the United States, and indeed has, I think, a very respectful relationship and a very close cooperation also with Israel. So if the army indeed takes over, I think this will be a stabilizing effect, and all the factors you've mentioned, the smuggling and Hamas and others, will indeed be under control. The question is, how long will the army indeed maintain power? I don't think this is a very short-term thing. You must remember, the army indeed has been in power in Egypt before, with Naguib, with Nasser, and indeed Hosni Mubarak was a very senior general in the army. So we could very well see a lengthy period of the army trying to stabilize Egypt and at the same time steer it towards democracy.
Our apologies as we've lost Ambassador Gillerman's feed, but we'll try to get that reconnected. Sometimes that happens. Obviously, he's coming from Tel Aviv, and he's back. Ambassador, my apologies. You got interrupted by a satellite feed snafu, but let me pick up sort of where you left off in talking about the effects this will have on Israel. One of the things that Americans watch very closely, obviously Israel watches very closely, is potential resolution of the Israeli-Palestinian conflict. There are some analysts who say now with Mubarak gone, and even with a democratically elected new regime coming in, whether it's now, whether it's in September or later than that, their predictions are you can kiss that process goodbye, that Mideast peace process between Israel and Palestine, because a Mubarak-run government in Egypt, who Israel trusts, will no longer be there. Your thoughts on it?
Well, Megan, as you know, this uprising in Egypt had nothing to do with the Israeli-Palestinian conflict or with Israel. This was the Egyptian people demanding a better quality of life and education and employment and freedom. And I hope they get it. And I don't see why we should not, at the same time as we watched events in Egypt very cautiously, very anxiously and very carefully, also proceed with the Israeli-Palestinian peace process. I think that this peace process is important for Israel, for the Palestinians, and for the region. The conflict is not the cause of the problems in the Middle East, but the conflict is something that should be put aside, and I think that both Israel and the Palestinians have a responsibility to restart the peace process. As I said before, I think it should be confidential, I think it should be behind closed doors, but I think it should restart and continue, because at the end of the day, this is what Israelis and Palestinians want, to live in peace and security side by side. And I think this is what most Arab countries want. And indeed, I think we would need the support of whoever is in power in Egypt. And I think the army may very well be in support of maintaining the peace with Israel and also promoting peace between Israel and the Palestinians. But I think that the whole Arab world at the end of the day should endorse those talks, legitimize the Palestinian leader who goes for a fair settlement. And at the end of the day, hopefully, what we'll see is not just a two-state solution, but a 23-state solution, which will mean normalization, recognition, and peace between Israel and the Arab world, hopefully a more democratic Arab world than it is today, following the events in Egypt.
Ambassador, I want to ask you one further question, then I want to get to James Rosen, who's got breaking news at the State Department. And I also want to let our viewers know that the White House is now confirming that the president will speak to the issue of Egypt in less than 10 minutes. So we will have that for you here as expected. Those will be important comments to listen to. Ambassador Gillerman, some in Egypt, some officials of the Mubarak regime are reportedly, and I quote, infuriated with the White House for its criticism of the Egyptian response to this uprising. They felt that President Obama, that the United States should have gotten much more behind this regime in whatever way it needed to, subtly, behind the scenes, or up front, than it did. Do you share those concerns?
Well, Megan, I feel very fortunate to be the warm-up act for President Obama, but I think it would be presumptuous of me to give him advice. What I can tell you is that his immediate response to this crisis and his rather hasty and maybe premature demand for the immediate departure of President Mubarak was not a very encouraging omen and a very positive message for the United States allies, because at the end of the day, whether it's the Saudis or the Gulf states or other countries who rely on the United States, they ask themselves, can they count on the U.S.? Will it be there for them when needed? And I think that the message sent out was a worrying one. I think in the meantime, I think the president has truly walked a very, very delicate tightrope and a very delicate balance. And I think that maybe the things as they develop now will end in a more positive way than looked at the beginning. But I think that in the future, the response should be much more measured, much more responsible, and I hope it will be.
Ambassador Dan Gillerman, thank you so much for your thoughts on it. We appreciate it, as always.